All right, now to the latest on the other fire that has burned all morning. A tough fire to fight on the hillside in Troy Hill. And now we're talking about three homes that have been gutted there. Channel 4 Action News reporter Amber DeCocher joins us live there with much more on where this fire originally started and what happened. Amber.
Well, arson investigators just left, but firefighters are back on the scene. They're putting out a few hot spots called out there about an hour ago. But I want you to check out, though, how narrow these streets are here in Troy Hill. That certainly proved to be a problem for firefighters as they race to get to this place.
I'm in shock.
The house Mark Azen lived with his parents the last 31 years, gone. Fire destroying the outside and everything they owned.
My mom starts screaming, fire. Because a ball of fire broke through her side window from the middle house. So she got us up. I mean, all we had was a shirt on our backs.
For more than 2 hours, firefighters battled flames and heavy smoke. The fire started in a vacant house on Elbow Street that just yesterday was condemned. When crews arrived, the two homes on either side were engulfed in flames. One of the residents had just moved in. Firefighters have been called to the abandoned home before for fire, something neighbors say could have been prevented.
The vacant houses, the boarded up houses, it's a big problem in the city everywhere. It really needs to be taken care of before, you know, someone gets hurt or dies in one of these fires.
One firefighter did get hurt. He was taken away on a stretcher and rushed to the hospital.
As he stepped off the ladder onto the decking, he was on the railing, his foot slipped and he lost his balance. He was able to sort of grab onto a hose line as he fell, so that sort of broke his fall.
Narrow streets and the proximity of the homes proving to be difficult for crews. Meanwhile, as firefighters look for a cause, the victims look for help and where they'll go next.
Anything and everything that we can possibly get, anything would be nice.
Now, a lot of people here have been concerned about those victims. Anyone wishing to help them can call the number at the bottom of your screen. As for that firefighter, he's expected to be okay, but this fire remains under investigation. Reporting live from Troy Hill, Amber DeCocher, Channel 4 Action News.